Not that long ago, myself and Corey Diligent, we did a story on Chris Smith from Crisscross, talking about what he's up to, maybe sharing some stories. Had a great response from a lot of his fans. Then, just probably 2-3 days ago, Corey reaches out to me. He says, "Yo, Nick, I got this incredible story I want to share with Chris Smith's fans. And all I'm going to say is, get your popcorn ready." Well, Corey, I got a drink.
You got a drink?
I got my popcorn.
Okay.
The floor is yours, my friend.
Okay. Well, Nick, this story right here, man, I tell you, man, it's a little lengthy, man, but I think it's going to be worth it, man, for all the Chris Smith fans, the Chris Cross fans, and definitely, man, rest in peace to Chris Kelly, man, when I tell this story. You know what I'm saying? Okay, let's go back to 1993, okay? So in eighth grade, as you know, Chris Cross and I attended Bunch Middle School together, along with Young Dro and Polo the Don, Rocco the Don. I know we spoke about that. But just for the viewers who doesn't know, I just wanted to reiterate that. So back in eighth grade, we went on a trip to Disney World, okay? It was sponsored by the Beta Club. Now, just a quick background, the Beta Club, to get into the Beta Club, you had to be either on the honor roll. We had a thing called Honors Plus or the Principals List. Honors Plus was like 3.5 to 3.9. It was like in between honor roll and Principals List, okay? So everyone who had these grade point averages, me being one of the students, you know, had an opportunity to be in the Beta Club and to go on the trip. Well, everyone who made the Honor Roll, Honors Plus, Principals List wasn't in the Beta Club because they didn't sign up, or their parents didn't sign them up, or they didn't want to do it. So when they sponsored the trip, they did it for the whole eighth grade class, whether you were in the Beta Club or not, but you had to be on the Honor Roll. So I just want to clarify that. Okay, so Chris wasn't in the Beta Club, but he went on the trip because he was an honor student. You know what I'm saying? He always got good grades. So, okay, let's get to the story. Okay, so the night we're about to go to Florida. Okay, so the charter bus is outside. So we all meet in the cafeteria, you know. And so I remember when Chris walked in, him and his mom, you know, walked in. And so Mrs. Smith asked me and Leroy, she said, "Come here, you know, I need to talk to you and Leroy for a second." So we go over there. "Yes, Miss Smith." "Yes, ma'am." She said, "Now, this is the first time Chris has been out of town without a family member with him. Looney or Jennifer, you know, any of his dad, anybody, you know, this is first time. So please, man, just please, please, please just watch after him. Be careful. Y'all be safe, man. Safety first." You know, I'm paraphrasing, but that's basically what she said. Just
makes sense.
No matter where Chris go, y'all be with Chris. You know what I'm saying? Make sure he's safe. Now, another part of it, Nick, is that Sydney, his bodyguard, who you may have seen in pictures on social media, he also attended the trip with us as well. And we'll speak about Sydney a little later on. Okay, so we're getting ready to go, you know, on the bus to get ready to go down to Florida. So when we get on the bus, Mrs. Fletcher was one of our chaperones. It was Miss Fletcher and Mrs. Colebrook. You're going to hear those names throughout the story. Well, they were over the Beta Club. So, you know, Mrs. Fletcher needed one of the students to run back inside to get something. So, you know I'm a married man, be 15 years in May, but I kind of had a crush on Miss Fletcher a little bit. You know, she was kind of like Miss Park and Friday, you know, without the shorts and the water hole. You know? So I kind of like Miss Fletcher. I'll be honest, you know, 12-year-old.
Miss Fletcher. All right.
Okay.
Miss Fletcher got it going on.
Yeah. So Miss Fletcher, she said, "Hey, I need someone to, you know, going to school. I forgot something. Can someone run that get?" So of course, I go get it, Miss Fletcher, you know? So I go in there and get whatever it was. Now, when we were on the bus, Leroy sat next to Chris. I sat across from Chris in the adjacent row, okay? So when I go get, you know, whatever Miss Fletcher needed, I come back. My seat is taken. My seat is taken. Now, you would think I would say, "Hey, man, get up. That's my seat," you know? But by the time I got on the bus, they said, "Everybody sit down. We got to go because we want to, you know, we had to get down there by a certain time and everything." So I lost my seat in the back. So I end up sitting in the front with all the chaperones. Oh, man. 8 hours, man, sitting up there. I was up there with Sydney because Sydney sat in the front with all the other chaperones
teaching
everybody. Right. So, man, I had to ride 8 hours in the front. Okay. So a part of me feel like, you know, Chris was behind it. Like he kind of pranked me in a way, you know, like, "Hey, well, Corey, get up, man, take your seat," you know, but we'll get to Chris prankish ways in a minute. Okay, so we leave, you know, Atlanta, leave Bunch Middle School, get down to the hotel in Florida, right? Now, when we get down there, Leroy say, "Hey, I got showered because it was me, Leroy, and Chris in one room. Sydney had the room next to us. So we had our own room and Sydney was next to us, just to give you an idea. Okay, so Leroy said, hey man, I called shower. So Leroy wanted to get in the shower first when we got up there. So, you know, we go in, check in, go up to the room, everything. So Leroy goes in the shower, like you said. So Leroy had a sub sandwich. Man, Nick, I'll never forget this, man. Leroy had a sub sandwich, Nick, and he laid it on his bed. And you could tell, like, when he came out that shower, that sub sandwich was the first thing he was going for. So he go in the shower or whatever. Now, I'm listening to my Walkman. Chris listened to his Walkman. So, you know, Chris, like, hey, Corey. Like, what's up, Chris? What's up? He like, hey, let me see your lotion. So I'm thinking he's going to use a lotion on his hands, you know, on his arms, you know, just use it on himself, you know. So I give him the lotion. He took the lotion, lifted up the top of the sandwich, and put lotion where the mayonnaise was in Leroy's sandwich while he was in the shower.
Oh, my.
This is a true story. True story. I'm not adding nothing to the story. I ain't going to take nothing away from it. True story. So Leroy's in the shower. He put the lotion on there. And I think he might, you know, just squirt the lotion just one time. And put, man, he put it on there pretty good. You know?
So, isn't that, you know, poisonous?
How you said what?
Isn't that poisonous?
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm not a health expert. What do I know?
If it was poisonous or not. So
probably not. But
he puts the lotion on the sandwich, right? And so Chris puts the top back on there. Leroy come. I'm talking about Nick. When Leroy came out of the shower, he went straight for that sandwich. It was no stopping him. Like, you could say he thought about that sandwich in the shower. So he come out the shower. Man, he went for that sandwich. I just dropped my head, Nick. He took the biggest bite of a sub sandwich I've ever seen in my life. I'm dead serious. He bit the sandwich and he chewing. I just dropped my head. He's like, hey, man. He spit it out. He's like, man, what happened to my sandwich, man? Man, you know, he's mad or whatever. And so eventually I said, hey, man, Chris, put lotion in your sandwich while you're in the shop.
Oh, man, you told him.
Chris, man, come on, man. I wanted that sandwich, man. And so Chris, man, I'm telling you, man, he had his prankish ways, okay? So that's one thing that happened. Let's continue with the story. Okay, so that happened or whatnot, right? Okay, so after that, Chris told us, Chris didn't ride back to on the bus with us back to Atlanta. He had to fly out to New York to shoot the cover to the Bomb album for that second
this
album.
Is right after the trip. He went for the Bomb
right,
cover
right after
shoot.
The trip.
Okay.
Yeah, he left a day before we left and flew out with Sydney, but everyone didn't know that. Just me, Leroy, Sydney, you know, only a few people knew, you know, it was very secretive. So he didn't return back with us. So back to the story. Okay, so that day went by. So the next day, we go to Disney World. Now, I forgot a part. When Chris came on the trip, Nick, he had cornrows in his hair. This is the first time I ever seen Chris with cornrows, you know, because, you know, they kind of plaited their braids for the most part doing right. Totally crossed out. They didn't wear cornrows. So
right
he wore cornrows for the trip to kind of disguise himself. And he had on the Cypress Hill bandana. Because remember, Cypress Hill was signed on the same label as Criss Cross and the Fugees. Okay, so he had on his Cypress Hill bandana and his cornrows to kind of disguise himself a little bit. Okay, so we're going to Disney World. So when we go downstairs, you know, everyone's on the bus, you know, ready to go or whatnot. So Miss Fletcher come on the bus and said, man, Corey, where Leroy at? And I said, Miss Smith, I'm sorry, Miss Smith, Miss Fletcher, Leroy's upstairs, you know, with Chris. They're going to come down in a second with Sydney. And all Leroy was doing is what Miss Smith asked him to do at the beginning of the story. Stay with Chris. I just went on downstairs. And Leroy's going to come down with Chris, you know. Man, Miss Fletcher was mad, Nick. Man, Leroy walked down there. Man, Miss Fletcher went off on Leroy. I don't know what was said. I could just see her outside kind of getting on Leroy. Man, Leroy stomp on the bus and, you know, Miss Fletcher, come on. He ain't no Criss Cross. Who he think he is? You know, she was just all, but she didn't, but to Miss Fletcher, to all due respect, Miss Fletcher, it ain't like she knew what Miss Smith had told us. And I think this is a misunderstanding. Like, I think she thought Leroy was trying to be cool to walk down with Chris, but he was just doing what his mom asked him to do. So I just want to clarify that. So, okay, so that happened. Leroy got on the bus and he was upset or whatever. So, okay, but he eventually gets over it. So we go on the trip. Okay, so we're going to Disney World. We get to Disney World, Nick. Okay, when we got out, you know, we all were together and they just, you know, this is another thing. They had walkie-talkies too. I forgot to tell you that. Sydney had a walkie-talkie. Miss Fletcher had a walkie-talkie. And Miss Colbert had a walkie-talkie. Some other people may It may have been one or two other people, but I remember them three specifically just for Chris safety. They had walkie-talkies. Okay, so when we get to Disney World, you know, everyone kind of split off into their little groups and hang with who they hung with. Like me and Leroy and Chris, you know, went with Sydney and went our way. And then the girls went their way, you know, everyone. And when we met back up at such and such time at such and such place, okay? So we go, we walk through Disney World. You know, and every, you know, couple of people come, hey, he looked like the dude from Crisscross. And they were like, no, that's our cousin Mike.
That's our cousin Mike.
We were like, no, that's our cousin Mike, man. No, that ain't no Crisscross. You know, we were just trying to play it off, you know. And so, you know, as we walking, you know, going through the park, and I kind of try to speed this up. So, you know, we go through the park, we ride, rise, eat, do all that. And so we get ready to leave the park, right? What gives away that is Chris Smith from Crisscross? If you remember the All Right video, remember Sydney when he was walking in the front with Jermaine and everybody in the video?
Yeah.
Okay.
By Sydney the pool, if I'm not mistaken, or?
Exactly. The Crisscross t-shirt with the Army Fatigue pants. Sydney had the same thing on. He had on this Crisscross t-shirt. and you know, in my mind, I don't think Sydney thought, like, you know, because he wore it for the most part, that was his uniform. So he not thinking, you know, maybe I should wear an all black t-shirt or not wear anything Crisscross to kind of, you know what I'm saying, disguise right. Chris. Man, he had on the Crisscross t-shirt. Man, Nick, I really mean this. Chris flood out the whole park. I'm not playing.
Oh, no.
The whole park. So I'm going to try to paint this picture. So the school is leaving out the park. It's probably, I don't know how many students that was. If I had to put a number on, let's just say 30 to 40 students. I'm just guessing, okay? So we leave out the park. The whole park was right behind us, walking out with us. The whole park.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, so Sydney walks around. We're talking about thousands of people now. So Sydney walks around. He say, hey, I need everybody to stay back. I'm thinking like, man, Nick, this whole sea of people out here, man, about to trample us, man. So we get Chris on the bus. We managed to get Chris on the bus. And let me, here go another point. I got my seat back. This one, I got my seat back. Chris, early in the story. So I got my seat back finally across from Chris. So we get on the bus, Nick. They start beating and shaking the bus. I am dead serious. Chris, girl. They beating on the bus, girls screaming, crying. Like, I seen this. I witnessed this, Nick. And crying, man. We on the bus like this. Like, they beating the bus, shaking it. I look over at Chris, you know, kind of leaning in his chair and just shaking his head like, man, I ain't want all this attention. Like, but man, that really happened, Nick. That really happened. So let's continue with the story. Oh, the story
real quick, did Sydney have a gun that he'd carry with him? I'm sorry to cut you off. Does Sydney, I apologize for cutting you off. Did Sydney have a gun that he'd carry with him?
I don't know. Now that I didn't know. I don't know if he was armed or not. I'm not sure. That's a very good question. But that if he was, I'm just saying if, because I'm not sure. If he was, I would understand it with what happened out there, man. Because that could have really gotten ugly out there. I'm just glad we were able to get Chris on the bus and, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
And back to safety, you know. But that really happened. So so we leave Disney World. So we go to Red Lobster to get something to eat, right? So when we walk in, and I don't know if they had to say Red Lobster anymore. I haven't been to Red Lobster in a while. But we sat at a round table. I know normally they got booths and then they have the square tables, you know, for family. Nick, we sat at a round table. I'll never forget it. So we sit at the round table. And if you remember the It's a Shame performance on Arsenio, when me and Leroy called Chris, okay, Jermaine Dupri.
Take out the trash.
Take out the trash, exactly. Well, Jermaine Dupri had on the Adidas bandana during that, when he walked out with Nabs. Me and Leroy had the same Adidas bandanas on. I'm gonna tell you why I told you that. So when we in Red Lobster, Chris still had his Cypress Hill bandana. It was black and white. I had on my Adidas bandana, which was black and white, just like the one Jermaine wore. And Leroy had one, but he took it off by this time. He had it on at Disney World, but he took it off when we got the Red Lobster. So, you know, we sitting there eating, you know, Sydney, myself, Leroy, it was a few other kids at the round table. So the manager comes out. He says, hey, so I hear we got some stars at this table. So we looking at each other like, no, man, we just came to Disney World. We just want to get something to eat. We just chilling, man. No, man. You know, and so Chris looked at me. He said, hey, man, I think he think you Chris, man. Chris Kelly, rest in peace. I think he thought I was Chris Kelly because of the bandana. And, you know, I'm brown skinned, kind of like Kelly was, you know, a little bit like. Okay. But, you know, I think he thought I was Chris Kelly because he saw the bandana. He saw Smith with the bandana. So anyway, so I remember Chris. I know I'm getting kind of, you know, graphic, but Chris ate a fist sandwich. I just remember this. So after he ate his fist sandwich or whatever, he called the waiter over. He said, now I know this not on the menu. He said, but can you cut up some apples and put some cinnamon on them, like some apple slices, and put some cinnamon on them and, you know what I'm saying, bring them to me. It was on the menu that day. Man, they went back there and they fixed it for him. It wasn't even on the menu, Nick.
Oh, my goodness.
This
wow.
kind of treatment. Yeah. And I'm thinking, like, when he asked me, I said, they probably ain't got that. I remember even telling Chris, even before the guy came over, you know, I was like, man, Chris, I don't think they got that on the menu, man. You know, I don't think they do that. And, man, he asked, man, they brought him out, cut him up. Man, had the cinnamon on there, real decorative, man. So when we're leaving, so we get ready to leave Red Lobster, right? And so, you know, someone asked for an autograph because, you know, by this time they knew because they saw Sydney T-shirt and they can just identify, right. You know. And so they were like, hey, can I have your autograph? You know, when I was walking out, this one I knew they thought I was Chris Kelly. I signed it. I ain't going to lie.
as Corey Diligent or Chris Kelly?
No, Chris Kelly. I think I wrote Chris Kelly, Mac Daddy on there. So, I wrote it.
So this poor fan has a Mac Daddy autograph. <that's>...
Hey, I don't know if Chris knows that, but Chris, in 1993, if that person has that autograph who was in that restaurant in Red Lobster that day, man, that was me. That wasn't Chris Kelly. So yeah, man, rest in peace to the MAC. So okay, absolutely. so we leave Red Lobster. Okay, so here's the last day. Okay, I'm finna finish the story up right here. Okay, so remember I said Chris flew out to go shoot the bomb or whatever, right?
Right.
Man, now you remember in the 90s, Nick, we had cross color. Cross color
yes.
was the thing, like how we looked
at huge.
Sean John and, you know, Louis and Gucci and all this stuff. Man, come on. Cross colors, man, in the 90s? Come on. You
Where
know
was
how
that?
Cross colors were. Okay.
Yeah.
So, man, my mom, rest in peace to my mom, she bought me a fresh cross color outfit, Nick, just for the trip. And I specifically waited till the last day to put it on. You know, I wasn't going to wear it out at Disney World. We know it's hot outside because it was hot doing, you know, this time. So I was
sure
the last day, you know what I'm saying, to put it on. I mean, I had the Jordans to go with it. You know, I just got the idea how fresh it was. I had the matching hat. So I lay it out. I iron it. I lay it out. Now, when I lay out my shorts, of course, the pockets are up because we were wearing our clothes backwards, of course. So I had the pockets up because that's how I was going to put them on, right? Man. So we get on the bus, getting ready to go. It's a young lady named Ethiopia. She's currently the president of Motown Records. She went to school with us too. She actually, she's the one who found Chris Brown. She went to school
really?
With us too. Yeah. She went to school
same
with
grade?
Us too. Huh?
She was in the same grade?
Yes, she was in the same grade.
Oh wow.
Yeah, it's us.
That's
yeah.
crazy.
You can Wikipedia her. Yeah. Ethiopia had to marry him. Yeah. So
interesting.
But Ethiopia was on the trip with us too. And so when we get on the bus or whatever, you know, I got on my crisscross outfit, and by this time Chris is gone. He's gone to the airport with, you know, Sydney to go meet Chris Kelly and Jermaine and everybody in New York to shoot the bomb cover. Okay, so we're on the bus. And so we made a stop at the bus and I'm getting ready to get off the bus. It's like at a you know, gas station or somewhere, you know what I'm saying, to use the bathroom or whatnot. So, man, Ethiopia like, hey, Corey, what's that on the back of your shorts? You know, so I got up, I look, you know, try to look back. I said, I don't see it. What you talking about? And so she was like, man, so she kind of helped me pull my shorts around so I could see Nick. It was a big old stain on the back of my shorts. It looked like a old bleach stain. A big old bleach stain. So I looked at my shorts and I'm tripping. I'm like Leroy with the cell. I'm like, hey man, what happened to my shorts? Hey, come on, what happened? So I race off the bus. I go to Leroy. Hey Leroy, man, what happened to my shorts, man? What's up, man? Oh man, your shorts, you talking about that stain? Oh yeah, when you were in the shower, oh, Chris put toothpaste all on your shorts.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
So to recap the story, so I lost my seat in the back and ended up having to sit in the front with the chaperones when we left. That's number one. Then Leroy ate the lotion with the sandwich, you know, after coming out the shower, you know, ate a sub sandwich. That was two. Then they say three's a charm, right? Then Chris gave me with the toothpaste on the shorts, man. And we never got him back, man. So, man, that's a true story, man. I just wanted to share that. I know it's a little lengthy, but that's what happened in 1993 on our eighth grade trip to Disney World, bunch of middle school. Crisscross forever, man.
Absolutely.
Yeah, shout out to Chris Smith, man. You already know, rest in peace to Chris Kelly, man. Rest in peace to Chris Terry, man. See connection.